Well, hello to all of you. So nice to see you, even though this is actually being pre-recorded. So sorry I can't be with you live today, but it turns out I had a previous commitment that I couldn't get out of. So I'm going to pre-record this for you today. Hopefully you'll like the course-related background because I'm here to introduce my new class, Cybersecurity 2, the long-awaited sequel. Yes. First thing I want to say is if you did not take my first cybersecurity class, don't worry about it, because it's not like it was a prerequisite for this one. If you didn't take the first one, you can certainly understand this. It's more like a different class as opposed to one that builds upon the first. If you did take the first one, there'll be updates on things I covered in that class, but for the most part, at least 80% of the material I'd say will be brand new. Hopefully you also notice my background is backwards. Or wait a minute, am I backwards? Don't know. What are we going to cover? Well, we're going to start with the basics, introduce what cybersecurity is. That will be partly an update from the last time I taught the cybersecurity one class, but also it'll be new things that have come up since then as well. So it'll be a lot of new material about, you know, the scale and scope of cybersecurity, which has expanded rapidly, of course. We'll move from that into the idea of what I call governing cyberspace. You know, is anyone in charge? There have been several major ransomware attacks. We're going to talk about ransomware, by the way, and upwards of $70 to $75 million being demanded in ransom. And there's all this talk of Russian hackers and things like that. And the question is Russia not controlling them? Can anyone control them? Who controls access to cyberspace? Can anything be done about ransomware? We'll talk about all of that. Then we're going to talk about something that I kind of introduced in the first version of cybersecurity, which was and kind of, you know, blew everybody's mind, which is this thing called cryptocurrency. Well, even just a few years later, now cryptocurrency is becoming a much more permanent part of the economic landscape. And so what I'm going to try to do in as non-tech specific terms as possible is explain not only cryptocurrencies, but the blockchain technology associated with them. From there, we're going to go into doing what I call looking under the hood. You know, we all know that big data is a thing. In fact, I talked about that in the first class, but the question is, why is big data a thing? Where does that data go? What do we do with it? Well, that's what we're going to talk about, not just artificial intelligence, but other things like machine learning, what's called deep learning, what role algorithms play in all of that. So we're going to look at the mechanics of this because it's important to understand it. Most of the stuff that's written on this is written in very technical language, and I'm going to bake it all down into what I hope are very easy to understand terms and concepts. Then we're going to move into looking at, you know, the current state of things like Alexa and Siri and all the other tools that are used to, you know, enhance our lives, self-driving cars, you know, what's the future of all that? Where is it going? Should I be worried? Can someone hack my car? Can, you know, should I really say things to Siri and Alexa? Which one's better? How do we know? Should we have any of that at all? Should we be living on a farm, not connected to anything? And then the very last lecture, we will end by looking at what I call the digital reckoning, which is how law and justice continue to struggle with issues of cybersecurity and cyberspace. You know, where does a cybercrime happen? What crimes happen only in a digital environment? What is U.S. law doing about this? What about my privacy? What about your privacy? What about so many things? So again, for those of you who took the first class, I don't want to say nothing is going to duplicate, but there's some valuable information in terms of how to keep yourself safe that I think if you heard it the first time, you can hear it again. And if you didn't hear it the first time, you'll get a chance to learn how to really protect yourself in a digital environment. And otherwise, the content here is going to be largely, if not a complete update, then also just brand new material. So again, didn't take the first one. Please take this one. If you took the first one, hope to see you there too. So much going on in the world of cybersecurity. All right. I'm going to sign off for now and hope to see you there. Hope to see you in the class. And in the meantime, hope you're all doing really well.